All right, we are live. So, this is Stationeers. Sort of a restart on my Stationeers Let's Play series. The last attempt was a little bit, had some technical issues with the audio. So, gonna be starting over fresh. This is episode one, I guess, of the Let's Play. A couple of things to were mentioned last time, but we'll go over it again. First, I'll be doing this on Stationeer's difficulty setting, or Stationeer difficulty. Generally, I play on normal, but Stationeer, as far as I know, the main difference is that you have to open your helmet to eat or drink water, and that sort of adds a wrinkle in your early game survival issues. And the second thing is, I'm not using any mods. The game is early access, but it does support mods. Normally, I prefer to play most games vanilla anyway, at least early on, although I've been playing this for quite a while. There is one mod that I occasionally use, is this this mod that increases the amount of ore you get when you're mining, because while I think mining is an important aspect of the game, it's not the important aspect for me. And it doesn't really break the balance of the game too hard. So, like my previous example, or previous attempt at this, I'm gonna do a quick new game and go over just the gear that you start with. And then we'll exit out of that and start a fresh start. Just to kind of show you what equipment that you do start with when you first arrive on the moon. All right, here we are again. The Stanley Kubrick Memorial Soundstage. So, there's our lander with our gear. Let's see what we start with on our person. So to begin with, we've got our EVA suit. It's the basic model, which is a little fragile, but it serves its purpose. And to begin with, we've got some gear in our backpack. We've got jetpack fuel, of course, the medical pill, which hopefully we won't need, our handheld tablet, which is a handy little thing that can do a lot of different functions depending on which of these cards we've got installed in it. Our mining belt, which includes a mining drill and a pickaxe as well. Some road flares, which are some use, but they're also a little hazardous because they're very hot. And then this little solar panel, which is, frankly, if you're using that to charge your batteries, you got bigger problems. We also start with a can of soup and a bottle of water and a credit card that has no money on it. And then our usual complement of tools in the tool belt, including some cable. On the lander, we've got our oxygen tank, which is handy to start with a bit of an oxygen supply. Got a box full of seeds, as well as some fertilized eggs, so we could have some chickens, and some mushrooms, which don't have seeds. Construction equipment, we've got a few different crates. We've got a valve and some pipes, and some vents and a console. Extra battery, that's useful. Kit for making doors. Sensors, this is mostly stuff for creating an airlock for your initial habitat. Then we've got some iron frames and walls, and the parts needed to make those, sheets of glass and plastic and iron. Basic solar panel, that's what we'll need to start with power. Our auto lathe, which is gonna be the machine that's gonna build all the other machines. A generator for generating power from coal, which, yes, it's the moon, but it's a video game. We've got coal on the moon. It's handy. An arc furnace for smelting ore, and a couple of power controllers to help us organize our power network. Further around, we've got some more extra equipment, canister of water, and that will work nicely with our portable hydroponic set here. A couple of extra small batteries, extra wrench just in case, a couple extra rolls of duct tape along with the one we've got in our hand. Hopefully we won't need it, but duct tape works great for sealing holes in your suit. Portable scrubber, portable generator, and portable air conditioner. These are all good for short-term use in managing your atmospherics and your inside your starting habitat, but usually we don't use these. Hopefully we won't need them. Here we've got five different colors of spray paint. It's helpful for keeping things organized. You can color code things. Tracking beacon, which will be handy if we go out of line of sight of our base and have to find our way back. That works with the tracking card in the handheld tablet. The labeler, which lets you name various pieces of equipment, also very important for when you're developing logic circuits and things like that. An advanced airlock card, which probably won't use because the advanced airlock is a little more advanced than we really need on the moon. And some more road flares, as well as some flags for marking out different locations. But don't normally use those myself. They're handy to have them. And finally, we've got a little bit of equipment. We got a microwave we're gonna need for cooking our food. A locker for storing things, also handy. Tables. Each of these kits allow you to build multiple versions of these things, and one of these tables is the sort that we need that has power to it so that we can connect the microwave to it so we can power the microwave. Some extra bottled water, a couple extra cans of food. Here we have the ground penetrating radar, which can be used to help find ore that's beneath the surface. Although this version won't identify what kind of ore it is. And then this is the scanner card that goes in the handheld tablet to work with the ground penetrating radar. And that's it. There's a lot of stuff there, but it's just enough basically to get you started. Pretty quickly you'll have to start mining things like this iron, smelting it up, and building more of your own parts. Because this, surprisingly, won't go very far. So with that said, let's go ahead and exit out. And we will start a fresh game and see if we can make it. Alright, part of the reason I wanted to start a completely fresh game after going over the equipment is because we're under a bit of time pressure when we first start, and oh my goodness, what's my lander doing? It is down in a hole. There we go. Luckily, it's in a hole, so all this stuff can't get lost if it were to glitch out. I've never seen it do that before, though. So, first things first, we're going to have to get... Our first immediate need is going to be water, but we can't drink water without a place to where we can safely open our helmet. So first thing we got to do is we got to find those frames and get us a bit of a habitat built. Let's go ahead and drop some of the stuff that we're not going to need right away. Alright, that gives us a little inventory space so we can get the things we do need. I need these frames, walls. And let's see, where are those door kits? Take a chance on leaving my duct tape here. If I need it, hopefully I won't be too far away to grab it. If I happen to damage my suit. I think that's probably enough to get us started. Where do we want to build? We want a fairly flat area. That's the east over there. We like our door facing north or south so that, because what we're building is essentially going to be a small greenhouse. So what me and my buddy G call our Tater Palace. It's going to be our initial food supply, and it's also going to be a place where we can safely eat. Let's see. So basically we're going to have a sort of a row of frames that are the front part. These frames will be in my front wall where the door is. And then this will be the interior area. Let's go ahead and weld these up. All these need to be airtight, so I'm fully constructing. We can save us some iron sheets by just leaving these at the first segment. Nothing will fall through these, so, and they're suitable for walking on and building on. Actually, maybe it's okay to have the door on the west side or east side. Better not. What the hell, we'll do it. This is gonna decrease our morning sunlight for any plants we grow in here, but it'll be alright. Go ahead and get our doors in place. Let's see, we need a welding torch and plastic sheets for the next step. Thank you. acid. These are unpowered, but we can open them and close them with the crowbar. Which we'll be doing a lot of to start with. Then we'll have this to evacuate the atmosphere from the airlock room. Eventually there will be a vent here to vent the atmosphere back into the main part of the chamber, but for now we'll just use the pipe as sort of a storage tank. Now before we start putting walls on this, let's go get our oxygen tank in here because that thing's a bit of a hassle. Use a wrench to pop it off. Snatch it up. I think we'll set it right there. At the frames, not the walls. Now these wall kits are of course used to make windows as well, so.
Critical.
Ah, alright. Gonna have to get some water in us soon. Need to get this power controller placed down so we can control the doors. We're gonna need the solar panel soon too, and we'll grab this extra battery. Actually, the power is not needed for the doors yet. We can manually open those, but we do need to get the ventilation working so we can evacuate the airlock, so we don't lose oxygen every time we go in and out. Okay. Close it up. Let a little O2 out in here. it'll probably go to about 20 kPa, 25 maybe. That's all we really need, especially in a pure O2 environment. Sure we don't have any leaks. Alright, helmet's open and I'm not dead. That's good. Little sip, little bite. Close it up, lock it. Sun'll be coming up that way. Right now we don't have advanced solar panel. All we have is this one, so we'll set it up where we'll catch most of the sun during the main part of the day. This power controller to basically feed the other power controller. Some of this jetpack fuel is going to be kind of hard to replace for a little while. So what we've got here now is basically this is going to be our power supply input, just the solar panel, but we'll set the generator up soon. So this comes in, feeds into this power controller, which will feed that power controller as well as everything else downstream from it, which will initially be arc furnace, autolathe, things like that. We're just gonna leave these open for now. Now see, this should still work, as long as this is on. The battery is optional in these. They're kind of a switch for everything downstream of them. But also they have a battery backup, and in this case we're going to be using these to charge our batteries as well. We have a charger, but we don't need it yet. See, we still have power to that, so do want to get one of those small batteries to put in there just in case. Now, see, this battery is downstream of that one, so it's actually charging at the same time. It's charging off of that battery. Actually, you know, I might wire this different. Jetpack on. Now they're not charging off of each other, but just off of the power input, which in this case is the single solar panel. And that's pretty much got that started. We have a contained atmosphere. Go in there, we can open our helmet, we can drink, we can eat. Now we've got to worry about getting food online and water online. Water's going to be more critical. But we can't do that without being able to crush ice with an ice crusher, and we can't build the ice crusher without the hydraulic pipe builder, and we can't build that without the autolathe. So let's get that set up. First, we're going to need a place to build all this. Go ahead and use our drill to flatten this down a bit so we can work with it. Charging. Got a little sunlight on it now. And while we're at it, let's get this solid fuel generator in place. This will give us a way to use coal to charge up things. Later we'll need to rewire this a bit, because that can actually output a significantly more power than this is capable of handling. When we use it in its current state, it's going to be kind of inefficient and wasteful, but we'll work with that as we go. And I don't think we'll burn out any wires just yet doing that. Okay. bottle of water out of our supplies. Okay, we're gonna need some materials, so let's go ahead and switch up to our mining belt. Gonna need iron for sure. Set up here so we have a place to put this stuff. Almost out of iron sheet. But we'll soon have enough iron to make some more. Alright.
Hydration critical.
Full bottles of water left. That's it. We've got to get water collection going soon. So let's get on that. First thing, we're gonna need a furnace for smelting. We're gonna need our autoleaf. That will work okay. Autolathe needs iron sheet. Ooh, this is a problem. We don't have enough iron sheet yet. Let's get this furnace going. We're gonna have to pull up some iron. Reach has exceeded my grasp. The two. Yeah. Cable. Some plastic sheets. Thank you. Now we're out of cable. Also a problem. Copper going so we can make more cable. Oh damn, oh there we go. And the stuff we've scavenged. Interrupt that, we gotta get some iron going. Some iron sheets. We're gonna need one for that and probably a handful for other equipment. So six ought to be enough to start with. Well, let's go ahead and make 10. Hydraulic pipe. And we need gold for that. only need two, so. Started building. It's a little slow. So. Where are we gonna place it? I think we're gonna place it right here. Go ahead and make some more room. Probably gonna need more cable. Five cable I have won't be enough to hook it up. Almost done. What's this coming? Yeah, 18 gold left. I think that's enough for now, though. We're gonna go ahead and get this out of here and get some looking going, I think. Definitely need more cable. Cable's one of those things you just use so much of it. It's not expensive. It's only a half gram of copper. You get 100 cable out of a full stack of ore. And it's complaining about my suit power, but I've actually still got 47%, so it's much ado about nothing. Connecting devices to a network will sometimes cause a power fluctuation, so to speak. And that happened here, and it stopped this, but it didn't stop the furnace, so it's good. First thing we need is this ice crusher. Iron, gold, and copper. Not a whole lot of each, but some. That up. that back so the next time we use it doesn't just throw it straight out. We'll need the silicate eventually too. Alright, where do we want to put this? I think this would... We're gonna put it here. Iron sheets. Copper back up. We need more cable. I made sure to do that so that I didn't end up with a half gram of copper in the machine, because if I eject it, you don't get that half gram back, you lose it. So. Any of the items like pipes and cables that use a half to produce something, you want to make sure that you make that extra one if you don't need it, so that you don't end up with a partial gram in the machine. Now, we can crush the ice and get the water out of it, but it'll be trapped in the machine, which is not good. It's also an explosion hazard eventually, I think. Need a way to refill our bottles.
Hydration critical.
And there's where the silicon comes in. And we're gonna need pipes. Uh-oh. Lost our power. Let's get us a sip of water. Necessary things are turned off. It's charging, but it's slow. Start by building about 10 pipes. Power holds out. All right. there's our water output. And that's for gas. Which we'll also want to capture, but we'll get to that. Some pipes. So the water ice actually contains nitrogen as well. And we're going to want to capture that. If nothing else, it's really good for our jetpack fuel. Especially if you accidentally use the jetpack inside, the nitrogen is inert. It's not toxic. It's not going to pollute your atmosphere. Eventually we're going to have a tank for storing that nitrogen right here. For now, we're just going to use the pipe to store it. Now let's get some ice in there. Open up the mining belt. Have water production. But that's our most immediate need taken care of. First sip of moon water. Delicious. Okay. So that's water taken care of. While we're at it, let's get food taken care of too. Then we can really start building. And actually, on top of that, we have a concern that we haven't addressed yet. Some of our food that we brought with us is perishable. These eggs, they're about 25% decayed. Mushrooms, they're not doing great either. We gotta get a fridge built. And actually, there's no point in growing food until we have a safe place to store it. So let's work on that.
Jetpack on.
And that means we need an electronics furnace. Iron, gold, and copper. More iron and more copper. Well, we have Sun's starting to set, and our batteries are not doing great. Starting to use a lot more power. Probably turn things off we're not using. I use this to charge these batteries a bit. Still need 13 iron. And I think our electronics printer maybe will go over here. Means we're probably gonna need more frames because I think we're out. And more iron sheets as well. We're out of those too. We'll burn that bridge when we come to it. That's gonna take a little while. Store some stuff and go grab some more materials while we're at it. Want to keep these three iron and the one stack of coal because that's exactly what I need to make 200 steel, and we're going to do that before too long. And I believe I can. Maybe not. I was going to say I could safely leave this running, but there's actually enough material. Has it subtracted the material yet? I can't remember. And we'll wait till that finishes before we leave. I don't want it to make two electronics printers. Put that in there with the rest. Keep everything in one place. Pipe just hit. Store it. Power's dwindling. I think we got enough in that battery to finish what's gone here, though. Place this not right here, because whenever anything comes out of it, it'll just go in the input of this machine, and that's just inconvenient. Give myself a little more room. We'll leave it laying right there, though. We'll grab some more. Iron and copper, I guess. Maybe we've got what we need for the time being. Fill this bottle up. Run the generator a little bit, charge this up so I can swap it into my suit. Thank you. few more iron frames. Generator up. Sun's coming up. Should have some solar power soon. Sheets as well. More than that, though. Plastic sheets go. I think I kicked them.
Jetpack on.
That's unfortunate. Oh, there they are. They were hiding.
How
do the large fridge yet. Just don't have my steel. Small fridge. Iron, gold, and copper. For the sake of curiosity. Gas furnace. That's iron and copper. 30 iron, 10 gold and copper. I think maybe we'll push it. Furnace built. While that's going, let's go down here and grab valve. Also gonna want a passive vent. So we can vent the furnace when we're done with it. I built two so we can go ahead and properly to airlock. access this room into the main room. Sheets and a wrench. Iron sheets and a welding torch. Sun will be up soon, but we've got time, because we can handle these ices in the dark. Let's go ahead and do that while we've got the night on our side. Activate to melt the ice, and then activate to melt and ignite. Yeah, got lots of heat, enough pressure. And put these in there. Hook them down. May have to add more fuel. Can't seem to get it hot enough. And now the sun's up. We may guess in the meantime, let's improve our solar generation. Add a couple more of these, iron, gold, and copper. This down. That off for now. Oh. Weird.
Hydration critical.
That's the steel we need. Son of a gun. So, still kind of stuck. Gotta have that copper. Again to find some copper. Aha! Finally some copper. Don't know how much might be left here, but we'll leave that as a marker. How far from the base? Not very far at all.
Take on.
for that for now. Trying to make here. There we go. Fridge right here in the corner. There, that way it'll have power. Once we get it hooked up. Power connection though. This machine produces cable a lot faster. We should have power. Let's get these eggs and mushrooms in the fridge. Now we just have to make sure that we don't let our power run out. I think maybe that'll be our next step, getting better power production and some storage. Now we've got a sealed environment. We can open our helmet. We can harvest water from ice now. We have a place to store food. And think that's a pretty good place to stop. Next time, maybe we'll look into better power and start growing some food.